Pakistan's continuing repression of Gilgit-Baltistan is leading to a change in religious, ethnic, and cultural demography. The region has abundant natural resources, but people here lead a miserable life, as Pakistanis ruthlessly exploit its assets and control the region. To address the violation of human rights and other issues concerning Gilgit-Baltistan, experts came together at the Henry Stimson Center in Washington, D.C. in an event titled Resources on the Roof of the World, International Politics and Sustainable Development in the Greater Himalayan Region. They expressed their support for the people of Gilgit-Baltistan who want self-rule.
Pakistan's treatment of Gilgit is more like a colony. Pakistan does not provide any political rights to the people of Gilgit-Baltistan with an excuse that it is still part of the Kashmir dispute. That's why the local people have to wait for their rights. But on the other hand, Pakistan has been exploiting the local resources with impunity, without paying any compensation to the local people, like the river water or minerals, or now they're constructing dams in Gilgit-Baltistan without any royalty to the local people. So the treatment of Pakistan is more like treatment of Gilgit-Baltistan is more like no man's land.
The human rights situation, well, they are, in the view of people I represent in Gilgit-Baltistan, they have been illegally occupied by Pakistan for some 60 years now. And even though Pakistan has a code for self-governance and rule of law in Gilgit-Baltistan, it operates as a dictatorship in the region with no real input from the people. And they, many of them consider their human rights to have been violated for many years, and that they don't have a voice in the governance in their own region.
Since the annexation of Gilgit-Baltistan from the erstwhile princely state of Jammu and Kashmir, Pakistan has been guilty of violation of human rights in the region. Its discriminatory policies against the people are a cause of concern. The people of the region want Pakistan to withdraw its forces and civil administration, as they are used to advance militancy and terrorism. Pakistan's spy agencies, the ISI and military intelligence, have also been misleading the people of Gilgit-Baltistan in terms of religion and race, and have provoked sectarian conflicts among the Shias and Sunnis. This has led to the death of thousands of innocent people.
The most pressing issue in both Pakistan-occupied Kashmir and Pakistan-occupied Gilgit-Baltistan is lack of freedom of expression and political activity for those who do not prescribe to Pakistan's policy on the Kashmir issue. That is the most problematic, challenging issue right now, that the local people do not have the voice. They cannot really voice their concerns without fear. They cannot really hold the puppet regimes in both regions accountable.
The people of Gilgit-Baltistan are struggling for their rights and seek international intervention for withdrawal of Pakistan's security forces. They want control over their land and resources. It can only be attained if Pakistan abolishes the Kashmir Council, a political tool of Islamabad that enforces veto power over the decisions of local, judicial, political, economic, and financial institutions. Pakistan's decision to allow Chinese investment and other interferences in Gilgit-Baltistan is illegal and has been sharply criticized by the people of the region. Experts believe that Gilgit-Baltistan could end up like Tibet and East Turkestan if China's unwarranted presence is not challenged.